bad time with Erin. A bad time with Erin. A bad time with Erin. Hi guys, welcome to Bad Time with Eric. I'm Eric with Flame On, the all gay, all geeky podcast at nerdyshow.com. This is my, you know, bi-weekly Bath Time video, where I talk about comics, news, and well, just basically all things nerdy. Today, first I want to introduce everybody to my husband. Everybody hears me talk about the Batman. So this is my husband, guys. Jose, this is everybody. Everybody, this is my husband, Jose. So now that's problem solved. Anyway, there are a couple of updates I want to do. The first one I would like to do is an update about the X-Men Days of Future Past. Now, of course, as everybody here knows, that I'm a huge X-Men fan and I'm super excited for this movie. Empire Magazine did 23 different covers. A lot of them looked really great. I got a chance to scroll through all of them. I had no idea how many they did until it was going and going. A lot of them look great. Like Wolverine, you know, they had the young and the old. Well, the young was shirtless and sexy, and then the older one was in the X-Men gear with a little white on the side. Storm, I don't care. Kitty looked great. There was Iceman, he looked older. Bishop looked fantastic. Blink looked friggin' awesome. You had Warpath, we had Sunspot, so these are some new people they're adding to the fold. Then of course we had Colossus is still there. We have Professor Xavier, there's a young one and the old one, so that was great. So you had Patrick Stewart and the young actor. The same thing with Magneto, you had Ian McKellen, Michael Fassbender. You had Havoc was still there. And then they also included a Toad, which was okay. I'm like, all right, whatever. Of course, Mystique. We love Mystique. They showed Stryker. They showed Trask. They showed a couple of Sentinels. One looked like that it was in the future, you know, so we had a future Sentinel. And then one looked like it was in the past. So I guess where Wolverine, the movie Wolverine, ended with him. That Sentinel, that timeline. Then, of course, they had Quicksilver. Now, Quicksilver looked absolutely terrible. Okay, I don't know why. He looks like Bart. He looks like the Flash's Bart Allen. You know, Kid Flash in Teen Titans now. And he had the goggle. He had a little, it looked like the way the picture was, it looked like he had little wings going on. And of course, he wore silver because he was Quicksilver. He had the white hair, which is cool. And the actor, actually, the person who's playing him, I'm a really big fan of from American Horror Story. You know, I really like him, so I'm hoping that he does a good job. And they show what it looked like, a picture of him and Wanda. Wanda looked 10 in a little pink princess dress. I'm like, okay, that's what we're going to do with that. So, well, have to see what the Avengers are going to do with Quicksilver and Wanda. So hopefully that'll be a little bit better. So I'm like super excited. Rogue was also one of the magazine covers, which kind of confused me because as I heard it, when it's been all over the place, that she didn't make the the editing. She's on the cutting room floor, basically. Her part didn't play a role at all in the movie. She looked good, Anna Paquin, but she's not in the movie. So unless they decide maybe do something else with her, I don't know. So I guess we'll soon find out. Another update I'd like to talk about is Batman Superman. Now, Batman Superman, I've been excited for. I'm a little weary and nervous, but, you know, I'll see. I was a big fan of Superman, the movie, that the Man of Steel, so I'm hopeful that it could be at least fun and action-packed. You know, we heard about all the people that are guest starring in it. It is going now head-to-head with, last time I spoke about was Ant-Man. It's going head-to-head with Ant-Man on that May 4th release date. Gal Gadot, who is going to be Wonder Woman for the movie, she signed on for 3 movie pictures now. So this is my prediction. I don't see a Wonder Woman movie. I don't want to be delusion that we're going to have Wonder Woman. No, we're not. I really honestly don't feel that we're going to see a Wonder Woman movie. Hopefully maybe before I'm dead, I will. The movies how I see it is Batman, Superman, and 2 Justice League. That's my view. Or maybe she'll guest star in another Superman movie. I don't know. Or Batman, but so I don't really see Wonder Woman the movie. I mean, I'd be thrilled if they did that. Also, the big news was Jesse Eisenberg, I believe I said that correctly, is cast as Lex Luthor He's a skinny little white boy. I don't know. I don't understand what they're going to do with it. I don't see him as Lex Luthor. He was in The Social Network. He was in Zombieland, so you guys have an idea who he is. I'm sure you guys know by now. I don't know. I don't see it. I don't see at all him being able to do the Lex Luthor thing. I could be wrong. He could be a fantastic actor. You know, it could be something. I have no idea what he maybe is capable of. He reminds me what it looks like in Smallville. But again, we'll see. It's the movie world. Comic book world, there's a few things I like to talk about. There is, first, I can't believe I'm about to say this, excited for Punisher. I read Punisher number one. It's the same writer, Nathan Edmondson, who wrote Black Widow that, lo and behold, I was a big fan of. And still, I've read 3 issues of Black Widow. The third one should be dropping soon. And it was great. She is still solid and great story. And I'm really loving it. As well as, you know, I was a little hesitant to read Punisher, but it was him. So I gave it a shot. You know, I gave it a shot. I was like, what the hell, you know, I'll try Punisher. Oral suggested it. He was just like, if I liked Black Widow, I like Punisher, so I tried it. I loved it. I really liked the first issue. It was great. It was fun. It was a character that I don't know about. Again, this all new Marvel now is doing it for me. What this it's supposed to do, you know? It was all about doing this all new Marvel now stuff, you know, and introducing people to characters they don't know, and that's what it's done for me. So I liked it. Highly recommend Punisher number one. Give it a try. It won't hurt. Of course, my update of Child of Jean Grey. I got to read chapter 3. You know, I'm sure everybody read chapter 1 and chapter 2. Well, new X-Men 22, Guardians of the Galaxy 11. I read chapter 3. All I gotta say, Oracle from the friggin' Shi'ar, the Gladiator's little troop, the Imperial Guard. She, like, friggin' torches Jean and shows the Phoenix, and it was terrible. I was so upset. So upset. So, but, you know, you guys will read it, and you'll find out, and it'll be out in 2 weeks, and then you'll see more of me crying. The other thing I like to talk about, which is kind of exciting, comes out this Wednesday, is Green Lantern, Red Lanterns. You know, we have a Green Lantern book. It's $2.99, so it's regular price. It's not upsell, but it's a double-sized issue. So you're getting you're getting half of it's going to be Green Lantern, and then you're going to flip it, and the other half is going to be Red Lanterns. So that's, like, super exciting. I'm really curious because, Supergirl is going to become a Red Lantern, which I'm, like, really going to give that crazy bitch more power. I'm sure it's, like, scares the crap out of the DC Universe. But yeah, so she's going to be a Red Lantern in this. I don't know how long, but we're going to see. I mean, it's written... the Red Lanterns are going to be the protectors of Sector 2814 now. No longer the Green Lanterns, now it's the Red Lanterns. So that's pretty cool. And with that, it's written by... Red Lantern's part is written by Charles Soule. Robert Vendetti writes Green Lanterns, of course. Charles Soule is going to be at a comic shop, which is friggin' awesome. I got to kiss him at Heroes Con, which it was a thrill of a lifetime. He's really a great guy, really sweet. He writes Red Lanterns, Superman, Wonder Woman, Swamp Thing, Thunderbolts, the new Inhuman book that's about to drop, as well as She-Hulk. And he writes, I think it's Omnipress, Letter 44. All really awesome. I'm gonna actually get a chance to read She-Hulk tonight, so I'm super excited for it. Cause I really love his writing. He's a really nice guy. He's gonna be at the comic shop on 2814, you know, Red Lantern Sector 2814. Work with me here, people. So it's gonna be Saturday. It starts at 2. It's gonna be a Nerdy Show live event. So come down, it's gonna be a Q&A with him. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Cat Mills is throwing a great show. He did a Nerdy Show live not too long ago, and it was a blast, and people had a great time. So hopefully you guys will all come down. You'll get to partake in Nerdy Show live. Ask Charles Soule some legal advice, because if I didn't mention before, he is a practicing attorney. So ask him for some legal advice. You know, any legal questions, if you've been arrested, DWI, what have you? Ask away. So that could be fun. All right, so that's going to be a blast. So hopefully I will see you guys on Saturday. Thanks for watching so much. Click like and subscribe to my Bath Time series. Catch more Bath Time with Eric. Head over to the Flame On broadcast. com and subscribe to our podcast, Do the Nerdy Show. And please, hopefully this Saturday, I will see you at the Charles Stoll signing event. It will be a blast. It'll be a lot of fun. Aaron and Kathy really know how to show people a good time. All right, guys, so that's all I got. Have a great night.